If I must leg shackle myself in marriage, the lady in question should have more to recommend her.
Do not tell us you are hoping for a love match.
Love's the last thing I desire. But if my children are to be of good stock, then their mother must be of impeccable quality. A pleasing face, an acceptable wit, genteel manners enough to credit a viscountess. It should not be so hard to find. You.
Pardon me, my lord.
I never got your name. I was wondering if we'd meet again.
So you might discern if my wit is acceptable, my manners genteel. Are the young ladies of London truly so easily won by a pleasing smile and absolutely nothing more?
So you find my smile pleasing?
I find your opinion of yourself entirely too high. Your character is as deficient as your horsemanship.
You act as if I'm some kind of villain. When every other woman in London aspires for the kind of marriage I am offering, you must know that. You have been exceptionally clear about what it is you do and do not wish for. But has it ever occurred to you this might in fact be about what your sister wishes for instead? Miss Edwina seems perfectly capable of forming her own impressions. Perhaps if you took notice...
So now you claim to know my sister better than me. I have never met a man as brazenly presumptuous...
You do not even know me.
I know you are polished. I know you are careful. I know you make promises without so much as uttering a word. There is not much more I need to know.
You're smiling. I see my plan to win you over is already working.
I was smiling at the view, which you are now blocking.
Mark my words, Miss Sharma. By the end of your stay, your opinion of me will be much improved.
And you must be Miss Edwina.
No. This is her sister, Miss Kate Sharma. What must I do to win your approval?
I do not withhold it out of spite, my lord. I simply wish to steer my sister to the greatest possible happiness.
Do you think I can make her happy?
That is a better question for you. Can you make her happy?
My feelings would not allow me to speak.
So your feelings are too strong for you now?
Sure.
No. All you are doing, my lord, is toying with the emotions of an impressionable young lady.
I know she wishes to be happy.
This is precisely what I wish for her. I can assure you, happiness is not your strength. Exasperation, perhaps. Fixation, most definitely.
It seems to me you will find any excuse you can to keep me away from your sister. That is it, is it not? You simply do not like me.
Of course I do not like
you. Then tell me why. Have I done something to you? Why is it that you dislike me so?
Because you vex me.
And what is it do you think you do to me?
The only feeling you are in fact capable of engendering, my lord, is that of discontent.
Do not tell me what to do. No, do not do
this. Only a beat. Ow!
Are you hurt?
What?
Can you breathe?
It is only a sting, of course.
Are you certain?
How did he die?
He was stung by a bee.
My lord, I am so sorry.
What is it? Truly to admire a woman. To look at her and feel inspiration. To delight in her beauty. So much that all your defenses crumble, that you would willingly take on any pain, any burden for her. To honor her. To honor.
To honor her being with your deeds and words.
Is that what you want for me to reconsider?
It does not matter what I want.
I do not think that is true.
With you.
You are courting her sister.
And I have every intention of bringing it to a point.
Why?
Why? Because I am courting her. Because I've decided.
There is nothing appropriate about what you are doing proceeding with this engagement.
On the contrary, I believe it is the most proper outcome for all.
Oh, and what of everything that passed between us at Aubrey Hall?
Nothing passed between us. Nothing, in fact, happened.
It is
is clear that you have affection for Miss Shaw. The two of you cannot seem to stay away from one another.
Because she is aggravating!
Oh, is that what I just witnessed?
Need I remind you, sir, if anyone other than your sister discovered us in the library that night, then we too would be obliged to wed.
Nothing happened in that library. Though with the two of us being obliged to marry be the outcome you desire?
Of course not.
Then let us both be glad we have avoided such an unthinkable thing. Miss Shaw.
What a handsome couple they make. Perhaps he will convince her to stay in England after all.
She barely knows the gentleman. Miss Shaw.
Lord Bridgerton.
All along, you have been set on marrying my sister despite my every objection, might I add, and now you intend to cast her aside. Why? So tell me, what has she done?
She has done nothing, it is you. You have made this match impossible.
But I am leaving for India.
And it is not far enough. Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to far away enough to free me from this torment? If I wed your sister, it will bind me and you together for eternity. And I will spend every day of my marriage wanting you, dreaming of you, dreading the day when my last thread of honor finally snaps.
If there is so much as a passing look between the two of you, then this plan of ours will be for nothing. Are we all in agreement?
Of course.
Quite, Lady Lemmery. I realize I have indeed failed. And more things than you and father will ever know. I am nearly certain every last one of my brothers and sisters secretly despise me. My own mother at that, despite the fact I've lived the better part of my life for them. And yet still, all I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, is you. That scent. It has remained imprinted on my mind ever since the night of the conservatory ball on that terrace. Lilies. You have to stop.
I have to stop.
There is no other course of action to be concluded. You must stop.
It has been you. It has been you this entire time. Spinning my world off its axis, making me reconsider everything I've ever told myself.
I'll speak with Miss Shaw.
She does not seem to be here.
What happened? My valet saw you carry Miss Shaw inside.
Is she all right?
Are you all right?
It is all my fault. I do not think that I can see her.
Do not lose her, Anthony. You cannot lose her.
Lord Bridgerton.
Miss Shaw.
Are you going to ask me to dance? One last time.
Are you going to think this?
Do you want to stop?
Just keep looking at me. No one else matters.
Are you still planning to leave for India?
I have my sister's blessing, as well as my mother's.
You love your family dearly.
As much as you love yours.
I was fearful of losing you. It is why I could not visit you after your accident. I could not bring myself to. I love you.
I do not know what to say.
You do not have to say
anything. I do not think there is anything else to say. Other than I love you too.
I want a life that suits us both. I know I am imperfect, but I will humble myself before you because I cannot imagine my life without you, and that is why I wish to marry you.